Hello students, today we will learn the illustration number 2 under set off and carry forward of losses. So this question is asked for the year 2017 year question paper. See the question. Mr. Vaman Rao, a resident individual, submit the following information. So the first one, income from salary rupees 450,000, income from house property A rupees 30,000, loss from house property B rupees 34,000, income from interest on securities rupees 20,000, loss from cycle business rupees 20,000, profit from steel business rupees 10,000, profit from speculation business rupees 25,000, loss from short term capital asset rupees 6,000, long term capital loss rupees 25,000, long term capital gain rupees 21,000, income from crossword puzzles TDS rupees 9,000 and the value is 21,000. Compute the gross total income. So here we have to find out the gross total income or a 5 heads of income of Mr. Vaman Rao. He is a resident individual, so we have to compute the gross total income by adding 5 heads of income. So here they have given the information relating to the 5 heads of income as well as the losses from the certain heads. So we have to find which all the losses can be set off against which income, and the final, that is gross total income, we have to find here. To find out the gross total income, first head is income from salary. So here in this question they have given income from salary 450,000. So this 450,000 we have to take under the head income from salary. Next, second head is income from house property. So under the head income from house property, so he has a income from house property A is 30,000 and loss from house property B is rupees 34,000. So under the head house property, he is having a income from one house property, income from house property A, and loss from another house property, that is house property B, 34,000. So a loss from within the same head, within the head house property, he can set off the loss. So here see the rule, loss from house property can be set off against income from house property. So if he has a loss under one head of a house, under one house, under the head house property, then that loss can be set off against the income from house property if he is having any income under another house property as well as any house property income. So here total income is 30,000, loss is 34,000. So income 30,000 minus loss 34,000 will get balance loss is 4,000. So this balance loss, so firstly it is set off within the same head. Firstly, the loss from house property B, 34,000, is set off against the income from house property A. Within the same head only, it is set off. So, the balance loss, how much? Rupees 4,000 is a balance loss. So, this balance loss can be set off against other heads of income. We have under condition, if after setting off the loss within the same head, we can utilize the other head income to set off the loss from house property. So this 4,000 we can set off against salary income. So we have here salary income, so we can set off. So it is set off against balance 4,000 is set off against other heads of income. Other heads of income. So here condition is except casual income we can set off other against any other heads of income. So here we have income from salary, so this one we can utilize to set off. Next, D, income from interest on security. This is a income under the head other source, income from interest on securities we have to take last. So if we don't have salary income, then this 4,000 can be set off against interest on income from interest on securities. Even from the other source also we can set off this house property loss. Next, loss from our cycle business 20,000, profit from our steel business 10,000, profit from speculation business 25,000. So these are the information relating to business. So next is, there is no business related information. So this is a loss and we have two profit. So here firstly we have to see whether we have speculative income as well as speculative loss. So there is a profit from speculative business. then we have to see whether we have speculative loss here. So if we have speculative loss, then we have to set off that speculative loss from this speculative income first, because under the loss, under the head loss from business profession, for speculative loss it should be utilized only from speculative income. So if you have a speculative income in a one particular year, then we have to use that income to set off speculative loss, or else we have to carry forward to next year. So here in this question there is no speculative loss, means this profit can be utilized for set off of other losses. Okay, so here the profit, how much? 25,000 profit we have speculative income. There is no non-speculative loss. Then this profit can be utilized to set off other losses. So other losses we have, under the same head we have the losses, that is loss from cycle business. Cycle business is a non-speculative business. It is not a speculative, and steel business is also non-speculative. So we have profit, how much? 25,000, and we one more profit is 10,000. So totally we have under the head business income, we have totally 35,000 income, 35,000 business income. So this 35,000 income can be utilized to set off the loss from cycle business, that is 20,000 is a loss. So balance how much? Balance income how much? 15,000 is a business income left. So under the head business income, 15,000 is a taxable business income. This is a 15,000 taxable business income. Next we have the capital gain items, like loss from short-term capital asset is 6,000, long-term capital loss is 25,000, long-term capital gain is 21,000. Yes, under the head capital gain, we have to see firstly the long-term capital loss. So this long-term capital loss, if we have, then it should be set off only against long-term capital gain. So if we have long-term capital gain, then first we have to utilize this gain to set off the long-term capital loss. Okay, so first we have to check whether we have a long-term capital loss. So we have a long-term capital loss as well as long-term capital gain. So first, under the head capital gain, we have to set off this loss from the long-term capital gain. So we have total loss, how much? Total gain is 21,000. From 21,000 gain, we can set off only, we have to set off the loss 25,000. Means here we have balance 4,000 loss is left. Actually, this is the loss left. 25,000 is more here. So 4,000 negative value means we got a loss here. Loss under the balance, loss under the head capital, long-term capital asset is 4,000. So this 4,000 loss we can't set off against other heads of income. We have business income or a salary income, but we can't set off that this loss against other heads of income. So the condition says long-term capital loss can be set off only against long-term capital gain. So here in this year we have only 21,000 long-term capital gain and loss is 25,000. So this loss can be set off only against long-term capital gain, means we got here 4,000 balance loss. So this loss can be carry forward to next 8 assessment year. Next 8 assessment year, we can take this loss to the next assessment year, and in the next assessment year, if we have again long-term capital gain, from that capital gain, we can deduct this 4,000 losses. Understood? So this is about the long-term capital gain. Next we have loss under the head short-term capital asset. We have the loss under the head short-term capital asset. So short-term capital gain, under the head capital gain, it says that short-term capital loss can be set off only against long-term capital gain and short-term capital gain. So here we utilize the long-term capital gain to set off long-term capital loss. Now we have loss under the head capital, short-term capital asset, we have loss. So this loss we can't set off in this assessment year, we can't set off, because we don't have any short-term or long-term capital gain here. So this 6,000 is carry forward to next year. Next is income from crossword puzzles. So this is a item, income comes under the head income from other source. This is a income from crossword puzzles, means This one we have to take under the head other source. Under the head other source, here they have given TDS 9000 and 21000 is a value. Means the given value is a net value. So here we have to calculate. Here we have to calculate the given. See here, the given income from crossword puzzles, it is taxable under the head other sources. So here they have given 21000 value. 21000 value they have given, 21000 value, and TDS they have given, TDS given is 9000, TDS they have given 9000, means here the value 21000 is given net value. So to find out the gross total income, we always requires gross value. So this is a, so from gross value, if we deduct TDS 9000, we'll get net value. So in the question, they have given net value 21000. In bracket, they have given TDS 9000 is deducted. Means 9000 TDS deducted means the given value is net value. So to find gross total income, we have to write the income from crossword puzzles as a gross value. This is a casual income, so we have to take for the casual income normal 30% is a deduction. So here we have to take gross value, means we have to add net value plus TDS. If we add this value, we will get gross value. So how much to, this is a 9000, 21000 plus 9000 equal to 30000. So 30000 is a gross value. 30000 is a gross value. So this gross value 30000 we have to take under the heading other source as a income from crossword puzzles. So with the help of this, we have to compute the gross total income. So now we'll solve. So write the heading, computation of gross total income of Mr. Vaman Rao for the assessment year 2020-21. Write heading, computation of, so computation of gross total income of Mr. Vaman Rao for the assessment year 2020-21. So draw the column to compute the GTI. So one particular column and two amount column. So write particulars and amount in rupees. So first head is section 15. Section 15, income from salaries. So under the income from salaries, he has a income how much? ₹450,000. So ₹450,000 we have to write under the head income from salaries. Next, second head is section 28 of income from house property. So under the head income from house property, he is having income from house property A 30,000, loss from house property B 34,000. So first we have to write income from house property A. So this is the income from house property A. The amount given in the question is ₹30,000. Next, from income from house property A, he can set off loss from house property B. So loss from house property is 34,000 given. 34,000 is a loss. So this is a loss from house property B is set off against house property A income. So 30,000 minus 34,000 equal to 4,000. 4,000 is a set off. So this 4,000 will be automatically set off against salary income while computing GTA, while totaling the GTA. So we can write outer column. Next, under house property income, we got a balance loss 4,000. So that is set off against salary income, that is 4,50,000. Next, income from interest on securities, this is other source we have to write later. Next head is income from businesses. So write heading. Next head is section 28, business income, business or professional income. Section 28, this is section 22. Section 22 is house property income. Section 28, business income. So here under the business income, we have to write firstly speculative loss and speculative income. So first we have to take here speculative income if there is. So profit from speculation business 25,000 we have to write. Profit from speculation business, how much? 25,000 is the profit from speculation business. So next we have to see whether we have speculative loss. So in the head, in the business income, whether we have speculative loss. So there is no speculative loss, then we can write non-speculative profit. So we have profit from non-speculative business, that is steel business. Profit from steel business given in the question is rupees 10,000. So we have totally two profits under the head business income, that is 25,000 plus 10,000. So total is 35,000 is a profit under the head business income. And we have the loss. So here we have one loss, that is a loss from cycle business 20,000, that can be set off against in the same head, loss minus loss from cycle business. So this is a loss we are going to set off against the same head income. So loss, how much we have? 20,000 loss. We have 20,000 loss here. So 35,000 minus 35,000 taxable income, business income, minus loss from business is 20,000. So that is balance, how much? 15,000 we got, that is a income, profit is right, profit we got, that is 15,000 is a taxable business income under the taxable business income. Next we have to write. So after section 28, we have next head, we have to compute section 45. So that is about to capital gain. Capital gain. So under capital gain, firstly we have to take long-term capital gain. So long-term capital gain we have to take firstly under the head capital gain. So we have long-term capital gain, how much? 21,000 is a long-term capital gain. 21,000 is a long-term capital gain. So from long-term capital gain we have to set off long-term capital loss, that is 25,000. So minus long-term capital loss set off. So this loss can be set off against long-term capital gain. So loss, how much? 25,000. So 21,000 minus 25,000, how much? We'll get 4,000. That is also balance is negative value. So minus 4,000 we got. That is a loss. So this loss can be carry forward to next. It is carry forward to next 8 assessment years. So this we can't set off this loss, balance loss against 15,000 or 4,50,000. The condition says the loss from capital assets, long-term capital assets, should be set off only against long-term capital gain. So we had only 21,000 gain, that is utilized to set off the, so the balance loss is carry forward to next year. So close here, should be not added again. So close. Next we have to write short-term capital gain. So next under the head capital gain, next one is a short-term capital gain. First we have to see whether we have short-term capital gain. So we don't have short-term capital gain here, so we have only loss. So short-term capital gain is nil, so we have short-term capital loss here minus short-term capital loss. So this is how much we have. We have how much short-term capital loss? That is 6,000 rupees. 6,000 rupees. So this 6,000 we can't set off against here under the same head. So this is a carry forward to next year. Balance short-term, this capital loss is carry forward to next 8 assessment year. We can't set off this 6000 against business income or salary income. So condition says short term capital loss should be set off only against short capital gain. So we'll write next head, that is section 56 is of income from other source. So under income from other source, firstly we have to see whether we have any income from owning and maintaining horse races. So if we don't have, then we can go for the next income. So we'll see one by one. First one is income from interest on securities is comes under other source. Income from interest on securities. How much income from interest on securities? How much? 20,000. So this income can be utilized to set off if we have loss under other head. So we'll see whether we have left any losses. So salary income, income from house property, balance loss is 4,000, that is set off against salary income. Next, business loss, under the head business loss, it is set off against within the same head, means there is no balance business loss. So we have balance taxable business income. Then capital, under capital gain we have 4,000 loss, that but it can't be set off against other source income, it should be carry forward. And even short term capital gain, under head short term capital gain we had 6,000, we had loss here, so there is no this loss we can't set off against other source income, so this is also carry forward, means this 20,000 income is taxable. We'll see whether we have any other income under the head other source. So we have this is over other source, then other source come here, income from crossword puzzles. So we have one more income, income from crossword puzzles. So this is a casual income, is compulsorily taxable. So here they have given TDS value. TDS value given means we have to gross up the value, that is 21,000 plus 9,000. 21,000 plus 9,000 TDS we have to add. So that is gross value is, here we have to take gross value. So gross value is 30,000. So totally we have 50,000 taxable income under the head. So this one we can take here also directly, 30,000, 20,000. So totally we have 50,000 income under the head other source. So finally we have to compute the GTI. So all the transactions are over. So 4,50,000 minus 4,000 set off against salary, plus 15,000 and plus 50,000. If we add, we'll get 5,11,000 is a GTI. So should write note relating to what note is for the crossword puzzles. Crossword puzzle we have to gross up, since TDS given in income from crossword puzzles it is assumed that net value is given, so we have to gross up. That is gross minus net, gross minus TDS equal to net value. So net value they have given 21,000, TDS is 9,000. So we have to find gross how much, that will be 30,000.